Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another brand new Android Studio tutorial, and today I will show you how to use floating action button and how we can able to customize it. So in the basic activity we have discussed almost everything inside the basic activity. So we have discussed about using the menu, snack bar, and finally we have that floating action button. Today I will completely discuss about the floating action button and how we can able to customize it and use it according to our preference. So firstly we have the content main.xml. So we know that there is nothing inside the content main other than this activity layout. So we are going to the activity underscore main.xml where we have the floating action button, toolbar and many other things. So all we have to do in order to customize and edit this floating action button is just go to the activity underscore main.xml and move to the text, and we can see at the bottom we have the code for this floating action button. And firstly we can see here it added the ID, and secondly we have width, height, and have the gravity next to this height. So gravity, we can see in this gravity it uses two things. One is the bottom and the second one is end. So the bottom is going to set the floating action button at the bottom of this activity window, and the end going to set it into the right side. So if you're changing the end with the right, the same thing is going to happen. So the end and the right is going to do the same thing. So let's suppose we have to set it as just bottom, and you can see by default it's going to set the gravity into bottom and left side of this activity area. So I just want to show with some other kind of types like the center. Now we have the floating action button at the center of the screen, as you can see over here. And now I'm going to change it into something like bottom and center. Now you can see we have seen some of the applications like Skype and some other famous application using the floating action button at the center, bottom center of the screen. We have even seen at the Android contacts application we have the number dialer floating action button at the bottom center of the screen. So likewise we can adjust the area of this floating action button using this gravity. And secondly we have the margin, which is going to set the margin from the all these sides. So if I'm going to change, by default you can see it is the fab underscore margin, which is a dimension from this diamonds.xml file. So I'm going to change it into something like 30 dp, and now you can see the floating action button gone a little bit upward. Now I'm going to replace the 30 with 50, and you can see it's again going upward. And if I'm changing it into 10, you can see it is just above the bottom of the screen. So likewise you can also adjust it over here. I'm going to set it as 30, so 30 is best. Okay, now you can also adjust these both things in order to change the position of this floating action button. And finally we have the app then src, which is going to give the icon for this floating action button. So as we have discussed in the previous lessons, if you want you can choose the icons from this drawable. Right click on the drawable, just go to new, click on the vector asset, and from there you can choose many icons as you wish. I want to choose it as, like as we have seen in the default Android contact app, we have the dialer which is this call icon. I'm going to choose it and clicking the OK, next, finish. Now I'm going to change it into the dialer icon, so I'm adding it as. So as we can see we have to completely change this because it is going to call the drawable from the existing Android resources. So we are going to get the drawable image icon from this drawable folder, so we have to replace this at Android with the at drawable. So and at drawable then I see call black, and now you can see we have to replace this with the Android src when we are using the drawable file. So Android src, and if you want you can also change the color of this icon from here. So I'm going to double click on this call black icon, I'm going to change it into white. Okay, now you can see here it shows the white color. And if you want you can also change the background color of this floating action button using a simple line like Android background tint. And then you can even choose your own color, or you can choose from the color XML file. I'm going to use my own color, so I know that most of the people watching this video may like to choose their own color, so I'm going to set it as ash, then fff and blah blah blah. There are 6f, and finally we have to click over here, and now we can choose your own color. I just want to go with something like gray color. Okay, so now I have a custom color for this floating action button, and if you want you can also adjust most of the things. I just want to go and add a little more customization in order to match this floating action button color with this app window. So I'm going to the colors.xml and I'm going to change. Okay, so now you can see. Okay, now I have added a little bit more customization for my Android application. So finally we have to go to the main activity now. So as we know, the floating action button is already defined here, so I just want to completely remove it and do once again to explain it how it works. So I'm adding the floating action button. So it is everything same as that we have done in the text view declaration and the button declaration, and it is all similar to that. I'm adding a variable name as floating AB, that is floating action button, and you can give it as anything as you wish, then equal to floating action button, and finally find view by ID or dot ID dot the ID that we have given in the floating action button, that is fab. And finally we have to add the one click listener, so floating action button dot set one click listener, new one click listener, and inside this you can add any kind of actions you want. I just want to show a toast message. So I have added the floating action button with the variable name as floating AB, and finally we have added the one click listener. So let's go and try this app in our live device. Okay, so now we have the floating action button and with all the customization, and when I'm clicking it, it shows a toast message. So that's it. Thanks for watching, and if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, do it now. Once again, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in my next video.